السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى، وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، لا سيما المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Brothers and sisters, welcome to the 23rd episode in the series of Treasures from the Cave. In the previous episode, we have learned that Musa alayhi salam set out with his servant Yusha ibn Nun in order to meet with his teacher, whom Allah the Almighty informed him that he has more knowledge than Musa alayhi salam, and he is supposed to learn from him. And Musa alayhi salam was so determined that I'm going to travel until I meet him, I'll travel forever. And it was the sign of losing the fish, the salted fish. Once you lose it, this is the place where you're supposed to meet with your teacher, whose name, as we will learn, is Al-Khadr. Musa alayhi salam, in this long journey, along with his servant Yusha ibn Nun, betook themselves to a rock and they rested for a little bit. This is when the fish slipped into the sea. They did not perceive that. They traveled for another day. Then the next morning, as they were hungry and fatigued, Musa alayhi salam said to his servant, bring us the fish so that we can eat. Yusha ibn Nun said, you remember where we rested again is the rock? This is where we lost the fish. Musa alayhi salam said, this is where we're supposed to meet with the teacher.
قال ذلك ما كنا نبغ فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا.
Ayah number 64. Musa alayhi salam said to his servant Yusha ibn Nun, that is what we have been seeking. So they both returned back. They went back retracing their footsteps until they reached to the same place where Yusha ibn Nun lost the fish. Ayah number 65 tells us about the meeting and how Musa alayhi salam found Al-Khadr, peace be upon him.
فَوَجَدَا عَبَدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا.
They both, Moses and Yusha ibn Nun, found one of our servants. The Quran doesn't say that he was a prophet or a messenger. It says one of our servants. آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا. Allah Almighty says that we had bestowed upon him mercy from us. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. And we have taught him knowledge from us. Brothers and sisters, the greatest honor is to be a servant of Allah Almighty. And this is the best title. When Allah the Almighty admired Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the Quran, in the circumstances of the Isra and Al-Mi'raj and ascending to where no one else have been to, not even angel Jibreel, peace be upon him, Allah the Almighty says in the beginning of Surah Al-Isra, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. Glory be to the one who have taken his servant, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, into a night journey. Being a servant to Allah Almighty is the greatest honor. وَأَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. And the servant gets the closest to Allah whenever he puts his head and nose on the floor. Showing servitude to Allah Almighty is the greatest thing that a person can do. So Al-Khadr was one of Allah's servants, and Allah mentioned that in the Quran in ayah number 65. What is so special about the servant of Allah, Al-Khadr, peace be upon him? Allah the Almighty said that we bestowed upon him rahmah, mercy from us. And he taught him directly with a knowledge from Allah the Almighty. So this is a useful knowledge. Musa alayhi salam traveled all the way in order to learn from this man whom Allah the Almighty said to Musa that he has more knowledge than you. Then the following ayah tells us about the dialogue between Musa alayhi salam and Al-Khadr, peace be upon him.
قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا.
Moses said to him, may I follow you so that you may teach me some of the guidance that you were taught? The hadith which is collected by Imam Muslim, it's a sound hadith, tells us the circumstances. How did they meet? When Musa alayhi salam returned to the same rock, to the same place where they lost the fish, he found a man who was sitting there on the shore and he was covered with a white cloth. He greeted him with assalamu alaykum. Then when Al-Khadr looked at him and he said, Anna bi ardika salam, where is peace on your land? He said, who are you? He said, Ana Musa ibn Imran. I am Musa, the son of Imran. He said, Musa bani Israel. So that Al-Khadr knew already about Musa and that he was a prophet and he had been sent to the children of Israel. He said, yes, indeed. Then the ayah tells us that Musa alayhi salam requested him kindly, may I? Who's asking? Rasulullah. Musa, peace be upon him, is asking somebody who's not even a messenger. May I follow you, please? May I accompany you? Would you please grant me this honor? Why? عَلَىٰ أَن تُعَلِّمَنِ مِمَّا عُلِّمْتَ رُشْدًا. What made you better in this regard is the knowledge that you have been given, the guidance that Allah the Almighty taught you. That's why I want to follow you in order to learn from you. Again, that confirms the subject that Allah the Almighty said, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. And above every knowledgeable one, there is one who is more knowledgeable. And there is a very interesting treasure in this ayah, which is, you guys remember the reason behind the revelation of Surah Al-Kahf? The questions which were presented to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by An-Nadr ibn al-Harith and Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayt, the representatives of the Meccan chieftains, whom the Jews asked them to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the three questions. So Allah the Almighty has narrated upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has narrated unto him the answer to the questions, and furthermore a story, very, very amazing story about the Prophet of Bani Israel, the Prophet who had been sent to the Jews hundreds of years before the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a knowledge of the unseen. And furthermore, to tell them that even Musa alayhi salam, while he was a prophet, there are certain things which he did not know, which he had to follow another man in order to learn. So it is not necessarily that because I'm a prophet that I have to answer your questions. It is not necessarily true that because Muhammad is a prophet that he has to learn everything. By the end, he's a human being. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْ. That is by the end of Surah Al-Kahf. I'm just a human being like you. I receive the wahy. So if Allah the Almighty gives me the wahy, I communicate it with you. Otherwise, I have no knowledge other than what Allah the Almighty teaches me. So Musa alayhi salam teaches us the etiquette, the adab of the seeker of knowledge before his sheikh, before his tutor, before his teacher. May I follow you, please, in order to learn from your guidance which Allah the Almighty have taught you. And he thought it would be that easy. Especially Al-Khadr recognized them as Musa, the prophet of his time, the great messenger of Allah the Almighty. But the answer was very disappointing. It was shocking to Musa alayhi salam. It's like he has to beg for it. It is not that easy. Ayah number 67, Al-Khadr answers Musa saying,
قَالَ إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا.
He shocked them with the reality. He said, you will not be able to endure with me. You will not be able to have patience with me. You want to join me in order to learn, but I doubt that you'll be able to endure with me. Then he remarked, saying in ayah number 68,
وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَى مَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ خُبَرًا. And how will you endure what you have no knowledge about in order to make it easy for Musa alayhi salam, because he was kind of disappointed and shocked because he was rejected. But Al-Khadr told him that nothing is personal there. It is simply because that what you're asking for is beyond your capacity. Joining me in order to learn from the guidance that Allah the Almighty have taught me is within your capacity. It is something too big. But Musa alayhi salam have already vowed to travel forever until he would die this man, or he'll continue traveling. His ultimate goal now is to learn from Al-Khadr, peace be upon them. So Musa alayhi salam had to vow beforehand that he will endure patiently, and he will be quiet, and he will make no objection, and he will be a very good student. In ayah number 69, Musa alayhi salam says to the Khadr,
قَالَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِن شَاءَ اللَّهُ صَابِرًا وَلَا أَعْصِي لَكَ أَمْرًا.
He said, inshallah, inshallah, you will find me patient with you. I will endure with you patiently, inshallah, if Allah wills. Why? Because so far I don't know what kind of knowledge that you're going to teach me. I don't know whether I can comprehend it easily or not. So hopefully, God willing, remember what we learned.
وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَٰلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ.
Don't you say to anything that you will do in the future without saying, inshallah, God willing. So Musa alayhi salam promised Al-Khadr, but he was realistic. He said, most surely you will find me patient with you, inshallah. وَلَا أَعْصِي لَكَ أَمْرًا. And I promise I will never disobey any of your commands. Let's see what happened afterward, but after we take a short break, please stay tuned.
If I were to ask you about the life of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the incidents that occurred before his prophethood and in Mecca and in Medina, about the names of his loved ones and his wives and his children, how much would we be able to know? How many incidents have we memorized? Brothers and sisters, isn't it more important that we study the seerah of the most important human being who ever walked the face of this earth? Join me, your host Yasir Qadhi, as we discuss the most important biography of the most illustrious human being that ever lived, the seerah of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Join Yasir Qadhi in Seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. In ayah number 70, Allah tells us the good news that Al-Khadr, peace be upon him, agreed to let Musa alayhi salam follow him, travel with him in order to learn from him, provided he has to make a promise, which is not to make any objection, not to ask questions without mentioning to him the explanation of his observation. Yani, you wanna travel with me? You wanna follow me? You wanna learn from me? You have to be patient. You should not rush to ask questions in order to get an explanation. Observe quietly and you will learn everything. So he says, as Allah the Almighty stated in ayah number 70,
قَالَ فَإِنِ اتَّبَعْتَنِي فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي عَنْ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى أُحْدِثَ لَكَ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا.
Al-Khadr said to Moses, peace be upon him, well, if you follow me then, do not ask me about anything until I myself make mention of it to you. Until I make mention of its explanation to you. Deal? He agreed. طيب. The following ayah tells us the beginning of the journey. They walked together along the shore of the sea, looking for a ride. So Allah the Almighty says,
فَانْطَلَقَا. Now both of them are traveling together. فَانْطَلَقَا حَتَّى إِذَا رَكِبَا فِي السَّفِينَةِ خَرَقَهَا قَالَ أَخَرَقَتَهَا لِتُغْرِقَ أَهْلَهَا لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا.
Musa alayhi salam is not paying attention that every footstep is going to be a lesson, is going to be a guidance. But please, don't be judgmental of Musa alayhi salam. Don't you say, you should have been patient, you shouldn't have asked questions. Because by the end, Musa alayhi salam is not an ordinary person. Musa is a messenger who suppose whenever, if he sees something wrong, he has to correct it. If he sees a munkar, he has to change it. So he's acting upon what he knows. فَانْطَلَقَ They both preceded. They both started the journey. Until when they had boarded the boat. Again, the hadith explains how did they end up boarding the ship. They were walking along the shore and they saw a ship about to sail. So when they saw Al-Khadr, they recognized him and they offered him and his companion Musa alayhi salam to board the ship for free. They did not charge him anything. Al-Khadr was already known to those people. Then Al-Khadr did something very strange. Al-Khadr broke one of the boards of the ship. He plugged it with his axe. Then he tried to repair the damage. Musa alayhi salam was shocked. He's supposed to be a righteous man, a knowledgeable person. And the guys of the ship have offered us a free ride. Is this how you thank them? By damaging their ship? So Musa alayhi salam could not endure the scene patiently. And immediately he objected to Al-Khadr and completely forgot about all his promises. And he said to him, did you make a hole in it? Did you break it to drown its passengers? You have done something awful. لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا Now, brothers and sisters, I want you to record with me, with your paper and pen, write down the word, لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا And put a circle around it or highlight it. إِمْرًا You've done something awful. In the following ayah, Al-Khadr alayhi salam reminded Musa alayhi salam with his earlier promise.
قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا
Didn't I say that you will not be able to endure patiently with me? Musa alayhi salam just realized that was one of the lessons and he was not supposed to make any objection nor ask any questions. But before we move on, ayah number 72 likewise, I want you to write it down. Then come to the word, قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ And highlight these two words and put a little sign in between, please.
قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ Didn't I say, didn't I tell that you will not be able to endure with me? There is no you.
So Musa alayhi salam apologized because he just realized that was a lesson. But he's a prophet, he's a messenger, and he has seen something terrible happening there. The owners of the ship offered us a free ride, and instead of thanking them, you break it. So Al-Khadr said, you promised not to ask questions. And I told you that you will not be able to endure with me. In the following ayah, Musa alayhi salam was apologetic. And Allah the Almighty quoted upon us what he said in 73. He said,
قَالَ لَا تُآخِذْنِي بِمَا نَسِي وَلَا تُرْهِقَنِي مِنْ أَمْرِي عُسْرًا
So please, that was a mistake. I totally forgot. He said, do not reproach me for forgetting. That's an excuse. And do not make my course difficult for me. Was his excuse accepted? Yes. Was it valid? Yes. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, and this is in our sharia, رُفِعَ عَنْ أُمَّةِ الْخَطَأُ وَالنِّسْيَانُ وَمَا اسْتُكْرِهُ عَلَيْهِ So that will not be blameworthy for anything that we do it or not do it out of forgetfulness or by mistake or if you're forced to do it. As a matter of fact, in the sound hadith, which is collected by the Imam al-Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ نَامَ عَنْ صَلَاةٍ أَوْ نَسِيَهَا فَلْيُؤَدِّهَا مَتَى ذَكَرَهَا لَا كَفَّارَةَ لَهَا إِلَّا ذَلِكَ Which means, if you oversleep, or if you forget about the prayer, make it up once you remember. Make it up once you wake up.
That's it. You're not blameworthy. And there is no ransom for it other than making it up. So as human beings, by the way, do you know that the human being in Arabic is called what? Insan. Al-insan. And there is a whole surah in the Quran. It's called Surah Al-insan. هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Why was he given this name? The root word, nisyan, forgetfulness. Because this is a human nature. We forget. And in the story we just learned, نَسِيَا حُوتَهُمَا. Musa and Yusha, they forgot about the fish. And then when Musa alayhi salam asked Yusha about the fish, a day later he said, وَمَا أَنْسَانِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ وَأَنْ أَذْكُرَ. Nothing have made me forget it other than Satan. So nisyan is a human nature. Forgetfulness is a human nature. So Al-Khadr accepted the apology of Musa alayhi salam and he allowed him to join him. But did he explain why did he break the ship? Why did he make a hole in it or pluck that board and it was fairly new ship? He did not, not yet. So they proceeded and they continued in their journey. When they disembarked from the ship and they were walking, another big incident happened. That is presented in ayah number 74. Allah the Almighty tells us, فَانْطَلَقَا حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَا غُلَامًا فَقَتَلَهُ قَالَ أَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. They both proceeded on journey until when they encountered a boy. The hadith says that when they got off the boat, as they were walking, Musa alayhi salam and Al-Khadr came across a bunch of youth, boys. One of them was the most handsome of them. Al-Khadr, peace be upon him, approached him. He got hold of him and then he killed him. Musa alayhi salam could not take that. And he should not have taken that. Of course, he should have objected to that. It's an innocent child. He's not a murderer, he's not a criminal, he's a very handsome boy. And he's a young boy under the age of puberty, he haven't done anything wrong. So Musa alayhi salam said to him, أَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ. How dare you kill an innocent person who have not done anything wrong? Because he did not kill any other person. That is the only reason that to be killed. If you kill somebody deliberately, then al-qasas, it was also in the Sharia of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. فَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ. Soul for soul, life for life. So this kid didn't do anything wrong. He's just a kid, he's an innocent kid. لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. Indeed, you have committed something really terrible, something very miserable. If you remember that I asked you earlier to write the word Imra and to put a circle around it in ayah number 71, when he said to him, لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا. Now in this ayah, ayah number 74, I will need to write down the last segment of the ayah, when he said to him, لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. You've done something really terrible. Why? That would be discussed, inshallah, in the next episode, because we ran out of time. So brothers and sisters, until next time, I leave you all in the care of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Give thanks to Allah for the moon and the stars. Praise Him all day for what is and what was. Take hold of your iman.